Alright guys, so it is May 11th, and that means the roster update for MLB The Show 18 is live. So let's go ahead and take a look at who went diamond and who went gold, who went up in rating. My predictions, the only gold to diamond prediction I had was Luis Severino. I think he is going from an 83, probably to an 85. I didn't think Springer was going to make it quite yet. I don't think Gary Sanchez is going diamond. I don't think Didi's going diamond. So my prediction, my big one is Luis Severino going diamond. But if you want to see my whole predictions, you can go check out the video earlier. But anyway, let's get into this week's roster update. And boom, right off the rip, 83 overall Luis Severino is now an 86 overall diamond. I had a feeling, boys, I had a feeling. So his stamina went up, his hits and Ks per nine went up, his walks per nine and home runs per nine went up, as well as his velocity went up by nine. So he's got 40 innings pitched, 5-1 record, 1.8 ERA. Dude, Luis Severino, really, really good upgrade for him right there. Next up for his starting pitchers, Gerrit Cole. He went from an 81 to an 84. Gerrit Cole's been having a very good year. I didn't think he was quite diamond ready. That's a big jump to make. So we'll see if he has another couple good weeks, you know, another couple roster updates. He could definitely go diamond. So we'll see. Plus 5 to his hits per 9, plus 5 to his Ks per 9, plus 4 to his walks per 9, and plus 2 to his home runs per 9. So very good upgrade for Gerrit Cole right there. Now just one away from a diamond. James Paxton went up 2. Of course, he just threw the no-no. Even though he did throw that, I didn't think he had quite enough to go diamond, and he's right on the edge at an 84. So 82 to an 84, plus 9, plus 5 to his hits and walks per 9, and then minus 4 to his, or no, sorry, strikeouts per 9. Yeah, then minus 4 to his walks per 9, minus 2 to his home runs per 9. So James Paxton is now at an 84. Carlos Martinez went up 2, plus 8 to his hits per 9, minus 2 to his walks per 9, plus 3 to his home runs per 9, and plus 11 to his clutch. Aaron Nolan went up 1 overall. He is now at an 82, plus 4 to his stamina. Okay. Rich Hill went down 3, not having a very good season for the Dodgers. So he's still at a gold, but he's no longer at an 83. He's no longer flirting with somewhat diamond level status. He's now back down to an 80. Minus 7 to his hits per 9, minus 5 to his Ks per 9, minus 3 to his walks per 9, and minus 9 to his home runs per 9. J.A. Happ went up to a 78, so he's getting closer to being a gold. Mike Clevinger also went up to a 78. Damn, there were a lot of updates. Chase Anderson went down to a 76. Danny Duffy went down to a 76. Blake Snell, one of my predictions, a guy that I thought would go silver, and he did, up to a 76. Plus 3 to his stamina, plus 5 to his hits per 9, plus 6 to his walks per 9, and minus 3 to his home runs per 9. Sean Newcomb went up 5. Wow, pretty big update for him. He's up to a 75 overall silver now. Tyler Skaggs went up 4 to a silver, putting together a pretty solid season for the Angels. Felix Hernandez went from a silver to a bronze, man. Luckily, we have that diamond Felix Hernandez in the game if you want to use him. Walker Buehler, having a very, very good start to his young career. He went up 13, and he is at a 73 overall bronze. Plus 3 to his stamina, plus 25 to his hits per 9, plus 18 to his Ks per 9. And, yeah, that's a very, very big upgrade for Walker Buehler right there. Man, I think it's deserved. Miles Mikolas went up 3. Who's next? Brent Suter went up 6, so he's at a 71. Kyle Gibson up to a 70. Caleb Smith up to a 68. Nick Kingham up to a 68. This is the guy that was kind of flirting with a no-no in his debut. Matt Harvey went up 5. Now, the reason Matt Harvey went up in rating is because they changed his position from relief pitcher to starting pitcher, so that will affect his overall. So he's at a 67, but he didn't get any upgrades to his attributes, so don't freak out over Matt Harvey going up to a bronze. Okay, Jorge De La Rosa went up to a bronze. Blaine Hardy, Steven Brawl. All right, all these are commons. We don't really need to focus on these. All right, let's go to relief pitchers. Who we got? Drew Steckenrider went up to a 73. Matt Albers didn't move. Daniel Winkler went up to a 68. Brandon Finnegan went down 4. John Axford went up to a 67. Victor Arano went up 22. Man, that's a big jump right there. Matt Strom went down to a 65. Gohara went down to a 63. Tyler Cloyd went down. Buck Farmer went down. All right, pretty basic stuff. Closing pitcher, Brad Boxberger went up to a 72. So no Adam Ottavino upgrade is what I'm noticing. I had Adam Ottavino as a gold upgrade, and he's not in here, it doesn't look like. So that's interesting for sure. So Brad Boxberger went up to a 72. Good upgrade for him. But Norris went up to a 72. All right, well, that's pretty much for pitchers. Let's go ahead and get into catchers now. Wilson Contreras went down round two. Not putting together the best season of his career, that's for sure. He is now at an 81 overall gold, minus 7 to his contact against righties, minus 6 to his contact against lefties, minus 7 to his power against righties. His vision did go up, though, so that's good. Francisco Cervelli, one of the guys I had going silver, and boom, he went silver, baby. 73 to a 75, plus 4 to his contact, minus 13 to his contact versus lefties, and then plus 8 to both sides with the power. So, good upgrade for Cervelli. I had him, and I'm happy to see that he is going up. First base, Paul Goldschmidt went down too, so he is no longer at an 87, he is now at an 85. Borderline gold, just saying. Minus 7 and minus 12 to his contact, but he got plus 11 to his power versus lefties, minus 7 to his vision. So he's just not playing at typical Paul Goldschmidt levels that we're used to seeing. He still got 106 discipline though. John Hicks went down, but nobody's going to be really using John Hicks. Brian Dozier actually went down. A lot of people were big on Brian Dozier because they thought he could go diamond at some point. Problem is that average is just way too low. So he's at an 83, now down to an 81. So he is going down slowly but surely. Ian Kinsler also went down to a 78. So he's not putting together the best year of his career at the leadoff spot for the Angels. But he's getting older. They were just looking for a plug at second base. So, you know, we'll see if the offensive production continues the way it is, but minus 11 to his contact versus righties, minus 5 to his contact versus lefties, minus 5 and minus 3 to his power, plus 5 to his vision, and plus 4 to his discipline, though. Yanhervis Solarte went up 1 to his 77, so there you go, my Blue Jays fans, plus 12, plus 8 to his power, minus 7 to his vision. Wilmer Defoe went up to a 69, and Lourie Garcia went down to a 68. Third base, Jose Ramirez, already a diamond. He got a 1 overall increase, so he's now at an 86, putting together another really good year. Minus 6 to both sides for contact, but he did get an upgrade to power, especially against righties. His power versus righties went up by 10, and plus 6 to his discipline. Josh Donaldson, basically the opposite of Jose Ramirez, going down 1 from an 86 to an 85. So he had minus 4 to his contact versus righties, plus 2 to his contact versus lefties, plus 3, minus 3 to his power, and minus 8 to his vision. So Josh Donaldson's got to step it up. Eugenio Suarez went up to a gold, so I didn't expect this guy to go up yet, but here he is. He's at a gold now. Plus 5, plus 7 to his contact, plus 3 to his power versus righties, plus 5 to his vision, plus 5 to his discipline. So he's at an 81 overall gold. So there you go, Reds. Your collection just got a little bit more expensive. Jose Reyes went down 1. They moved him to a third base primary position, so that's why his rating went down. Eduardo Escobar went up to a silver. Good look for Twins fans. Pretty much up across the board, except to his vision went down 1. But look at those power. Plus 17 and plus 10 to his power. Killing it. Jose Bautista, now at a third baseman, so his overall went down a little bit just because of the position change. And Candelario from the Tigers, having a pretty solid little season so far. Plus 5 to his numbers against righties, and also plus a lot to his fielding, so good week for him. Alright, over at shortstop, who do we got? Francisco Lindor went up 1 to an 86, minus 15 to his contact versus righties, plus 5 to his contact versus lefties, plus 14 and plus 11 to his power, and minus 8 to his vision. So Francisco Lindor's stats look a lot different than they did when this game came out. Like, dude, that's plus minus 15 to one thing and then plus 14 to another. Like, that's a flip-flop right there. So interesting look for Francisco Lindor now. Andrelton Simmons now is at an 84, flirting with the diamond, you know, Simba, plus 6, plus 2 to his contact, plus 8, plus 6 to his power. He's like one of the league leaders in average right now. He's killing the ball. So, and you know, he's very good defensively as well. So, you know, he's playing good. Johan Camargo stayed the same. These guys, yeah, nobody's really going to use any of these guys. Daniel Robinson went up to a 66. All right. Left field, Eddie Rosario went up to a 78, having another good year for the Twins. Plus 10 to his contact versus righties, minus 5 to his contact versus lefties, plus 9, plus 5 to his power, plus 7 to his vision, minus 5 to his discipline. So he's at a 78. Good for him. Corey Dickerson, this is a guy that I definitely think was going to get an upgrade. I just didn't think it'd be enough to put him to a gold. That's a 5 overall jump. That's a lot. But he did go up to a 77, just kind of right where I predicted. Plus 7 to both sides of contact and or both sides of contact. Minus 3, minus 4 to his power, plus 8 to his vision, and minus 1 to his discipline. So good upgrade for Corey Dickerson, moving up to a 77 overall silver. We also have Matt Adams, went up to a 74. Very, very big upgrade to his numbers against righties. Plus 17 to his contact versus righties, plus 11 to his power versus righties, minus 2 to his vision, plus 9 to his discipline. Teoscar Hernandez went up to a 72. Plus 2 to his contact versus righties, plus 11 to his power versus righties, and plus 12 to his discipline. So this guy's a young player. player that a lot of people are excited about, and he's playing pretty well, so good upgrade for him. All right, center field. One thing I'm noticing right away, I don't think he's a right fielder yet. One thing I'm noticing right away is no George Springer. I didn't think George Springer would have enough, and it looks like he didn't. AJ Pollock, he got a 292 average. He's up to an 83, so another good upgrade for him. A lot of people are asking about him, but once again, it's just a very far jump from 81 to an 85. Plus 8, plus 6 to his contact, plus 7, plus 8 to his power, minus 6 to his vision. D. Gordon, this guy was somebody I was on the fence about. I didn't quite know if he was going to make diamond or not, or I'm sorry, gold. But I wasn't ready to pull the trigger, but he did end up making it. He got a 2 overall increase, plus 4, plus 6 to his contact, plus 2 to his power, minus 7 to his discipline. The contact and power upgrade was enough to get him to an 81. Good for him. Delino DeShields went up to a 77, plus 8, plus 10 to his numbers against lefties. Odubel putting together a very strong season with that on-base streak. 75 overall, now at a 77. Really good upgrades to his hitting, except his contact versus lefties. Billy Hamilton went down 1, minus 5, minus 7 to his contact, plus 5 to his power versus lefties, minus 7 to his vision, plus 7 to his discipline. So he's still going to be that speed guy. You're just going to want to bunt with this guy if you use him. Conforto went down to a 76. Minus all across the board except for his discipline. Minus 5, minus 7 to contact, minus 5 to both sides for his power, minus 4, 5 to vision. So that's not a great look for Conforto right now. Jacoby Jones, new center fielder. And last but not least, we got right field. Andrew McCutchen went down to a silver. Minus 6 to his contact versus lefties, minus 5 to his power, and minus 5 to his power against both sides, actually. Minus 4 to his vision, plus 4 to his discipline, minus 5 to his clutch. So McCutchen now down to a silver. Interesting. Nick Markakis, this guy definitely deserved an upgrade with the way he's been hitting. He's got so many hits already. Plus 3, plus 7 to his contact, plus 6, plus 17 to his power versus lefties, plus 4 to his vision, plus 5 to his discipline. He's at a 78 overall silver, almost flirting with gold level at this point with the way he's been hitting. So Nick Markakis 100% deserved an upgrade. Nomar Mazara up to a 76. This is another guy that I thought would get upgraded. Plus 5, plus 4 to his contact, plus 5, plus 6 to his power, minus 4, minus 2 to his vision and discipline. So good upgrade for Nomar Mazara. Jorge Soler went up to a 74. Good numbers all around. Plus 3, plus 7 to his contact. Ben Zobrist got a new position of right field. And lastly, Anthony Alford. And I believe that is it, guys. So the only gold to diamond we got was Luis Severino. George Springer has not made it yet. Sanchez has not made it yet. Didi has not made it yet. Any of the major guys that you guys have always been talking about have not made it yet. Luis Severino did get to a diamond. So far, I'm pretty good at my predictions. But anyway, guys, let me know if there was anybody that got shafted. Do you think there was somebody that should have got upgraded that didn't, or somebody that got downgraded that should have got downgraded? Personally, I feel like Cole Calhoun should get downgraded a little bit, but that's just my opinion. So yeah, let me know what you guys think in the comments. Are you happy with this roster update or not? So yeah, thank you for watching, guys. Drop a thumbs up on the video if you enjoyed it. I will see you in the next one. Peace.